this is a very important step that I'm going to take this year. I am really focused. I want also to perform and to see that if I can do better and add another gold medal.
Ni ombi letu sisi wote kama familia niwe mwacha yao ya wale wote ambao watapata nafasi kuwakilisha Kenya kwa Olympics huko London 2012.
There's still a lot to do. There's still much to sacrifice, of course, training. It's a long way to go.
The country would not be satisfied with a bronze medal or with a silver medal. We have to gradually, throughout the next 5 or 6 months, prepare mentally for.
Katika familia yangu tulisaliwa tukiwa saba na mimi ndio nakuwa second last. Wakati nilikuwa shule nilikuwa napenda mpira lakini nilikuwa nacheza upande wa number 8. Sasa nilikuwa na mbio sana. Mpaka mwalimu wangu akaniongelesha nijaribu nione kama naweza kimbia. Sasa wakati tulikuwa tunakimbia ya in the classes nilifanya vyema. Alafu nikachakuliwa nikaenda tukakimbia ya in the schools mwaka wa 95. Nikakimbia mpaka nikafika Kamarin Stadium, hapo ndio nilishindwa. Mwezi wa 3 ya hiyo mwaka 96 ndio nikakuwa number 3 kwa trials ya Kenya World Juniors, na hapo ndio nikachaliwa nikarepresent Kenya kwa World Juniors, na hapo ndio wakati nilianza kukimbia mpaka wa sasa. Mimi kwa majina naitwa Edna Kiplagat, nilisaliwa Kapkoi, kaunti ya Keiyo Marakwet.
Myself, I like running in school. Of course, every time I'm being sent even to town to buy something, to buy some sugar, etc. Always I was just running up and down. I like running. My father, my mother liked to send me because within no time I was there.
Alianza kwa primary yani. Akaanza tunjia akaenda sasa akafanya vizuri. Wakati alikuwa Kilgori Secondary School, akaikuja akaingia secondary. Akafanya vizuri ndi provincial, sasa akachukuliwa ile shule. Kijana shule ba St. Patrick.
I joined this camp in 2005. I won in my district. And the very place we came to sleep that night was St. Patrick. And I saw a tree planted by one of the greatest athletes I used to hear about. So I get to know that there is a Mzungu coaching athlete from this place. I'm very happy because this is the best place for training.
St. Patrick's A10 was founded in 1961. It's a boarding school for boys. Right from the beginning, the school had an interest in sport. The sport was considered to be an integral part of the life of any young person. Some people think, you know, it's an athletic school. But when you tell people it's just a fairly regular secondary school in Kenya, doing all the academic requirements and run like any other school, they're often very surprised. This is here to try to show to the present students what has gone before them. It's also here perhaps to motivate some of our younger students to realize that the whole school has such a rich tradition and history associated with sports, particularly athletics. And we're hoping that by displaying this, that it will somehow inspire our younger generation to follow in the footsteps of some of the great athletes that have gone before them. People here like David Rudisha, who was not a student of the school, but trained in St. Patrick's and followed the St. Patrick's program. This was taken some years ago when he had won the world junior title. That was really his first global success. And of course, since then, he has gone on to win other things. The first Olympians that were produced under my own care as a coach were the twin Cheruiyots, who represented Kenya in the 1984 Olympics in Los Angeles. Over here we have our first Olympic gold medalist, Peter Runner. I have a particular attachment to Peter because I more or less began his athletics career right from the beginning. And while he was growing up as a young athlete, I was growing as a coach. And I think he's really the one who gave me the confidence and a kind of gave me that extra little bit of interest and way of knowing athletes. Because when I brought somebody up like Peter, I began to realize that I can do it. I can produce some of the best athletes in the world. So he's a great inspiration to me. My parents were absolutely tremendous people. They were very understanding, very supportive. You know, normally parents, when you say you're going to join the Brotherhood, they might be inclined to wonder why you're not getting married like everybody else. Also, of course, even saying I'm coming to Kenya, to Africa, which to them was so mysterious, where sometimes only horror stories came out of. So in a sense, I had a very happy childhood and a very rural upbringing. I think it helped me to develop a kind of personality and character that's very appropriate for taking young people who have talents and developing them into superstars. I suppose a lot of the things I do are a little bit different in approach, because I need to get an athlete from the time they are 13, 14, 15 and develop them from the beginning.
He's very selective and of course he sees a lot of things. He sees your potentials, your structure, etc. You might be even number four in the race, but he sees something different in you that if he can develop, maybe you can become a better person. When I was a child, I knew that my father was an athlete. I used to see his Olympic medal, silver medal. It was so beautiful. It boosts my morale in running. Even when I was in school, I didn't want any other child to be faster than me, because I used to be proud that my father was an athlete. So I want also to show myself that I can also run like him.
Sinasikia vizuri kwa maana itaonekana kwa watu kumbe hata inakimbia kama baba yake samani. Kumbe basi ndiye amechukua baba yake ni kumbe anakimbia. Kumbe ibu zake kukua muongo. Kumbe alikuwa anakimbia kwa product. Sasa hiyo ukipanda nini? Ukipanda mtama na wimbi, si utafuna tu mtama kando na ufune wimbi kando. Na ukipanda mahindi, si utafuna mahindi.
My first race to represent this country was in East African World Youth in Arusha, Tanzania. I was placed second. I won the silver medal behind the Sudanese.
Then in 2009, he made the Kenyan team for the World Championships in Berlin.
Rudisha of Kenya, the World Junior Champion in 2006, the African Champion in 2008. And it's the big Cuban that comes across. Lopez, he's on the inside,
giving himself every chance of qualification, the Brazilian. He's seen what's happened in the preceding two semi-finals.
Well, there's the lap time, 51.54. He is pushing it on, and the tall, striding Lopez, the 400-metre runner, must be loving this. This is his sort of race.
And here comes Rudisha, the Kenyan. Rudisha trying to come up on the outside. The Cuban 400-metre specialist making a late surge on the outside. Lalu is going to take it. Who's going to get second? Rudisha just overtaken by the Cuban Lopez on the line.
It was raining, cold, terrible cold, yeah, and that really affected my warm-up routine, etc. And I find that it was very hard for me to react even the last 100 meters in which I used to be strong. So I end up missing the final.
I think that hit him very hard, because I think he felt that he was in with a chance for a medal. But at the same time, I think he was realistic. He learned from the positives, because after that loss in 2009, something like his next, counting semi-finals and finals and national championships and everything in Kenya, I think his next 40 races, he was unbeaten. Almost immediately, within a week or two, he went to Rieti. and broke the Africa record, which had stood for 25 years. So that was a big step in his confidence. By coincidence or otherwise, there was a competition in Berlin, the very same track where he had lost in 2009. So he went back into the lion's den, to the same place where he was defeated. And it was something that he himself, I mean, when he finished, he realized he had done a superhuman effort.
Kachinja ngombe, kachinja mbusi, masoda. It was the biggest sherehe we had to hatujakuta watu kilikuwa wanakuja hivyo.
Rudisha goes again with 150 meters to go. Pouring it on. Is he going to go away? It looks as if he is. Kolski, he may just get it for the silver medal. Rudisha gets it.
After he finishing in Daegu, he felt that once he crossed the finish line, as if a huge weight had been lifted off his shoulders. He felt so relieved that he had put all maybe the doubts that he might even have had in himself behind him.
But really, there was no question who was going to win the gold medal. The world record holder, 2010 Athlete of the Year, David Rudisha of Kenya.
I have two titles, that is world record and world championships. And you know, to be a complete athlete, I think you need to have three titles. And the most important is Olympic, in which I'm missing at the moment.
Originally, my coaching was confined to St. Patrick's. And then in the late 1970s, I started coaching in Singori Girls. Edna came under that extension program, so to speak. When she came first, she was a track athlete, of course. She's now better known as a marathon runner. And it wasn't actually until years later that she really began to develop as a marathon runner under her husband, Gilbert.
Baada ya kutoka kwa kambi ya Pratakolo, kuna vitu mingi nilikuja nika learn kutoka kwake kuhusu mazoezi na kuhusu vile unaweza kimbia mzuri wakati uko kwa race. Sasa naona yeye ndiye amekuwa mtu mzuri kwangu katika mambo ya mbio. Yeye alinipata mimi nikiwa nimekimbia mpaka nilikuwa nimeenda hata ngambo, maana mimi nilianza 96 kukimbia. Mpaka sasa wakati 2003, hiyo ni 7 years ago, tukikutana naye.
It's a teamwork marriage, because we combine our effort for the success of our family and Edna. The success for Edna is success for me, because we have to combine.
Na shukuru Mungu, maana nilipata Gilbert akiwa ni msee mwenye anaelewa mazoezi. Na sasa amekuwa akinisaidia sana kwa upande wa familia. Maana mara mingi yeye ndiye ananisaidia kwa upande ya watoto.
I decided my running to put on hold and concentrate in Edna, because when you see the results, the progress of Edna was running good. So I say let's give 1 year a try. And then I tell Edna, now, yes, I can become a champion, but we are winning small races. So if we focus for big races and want for you, I give you 100% support, I give you all the kind of training you need, you can become more sharper and you can win any race you want. At the moment, it's my duty to pick my daughter and my son in the school. Every now at 4 to 4:30, I have to come to pick them in school. Because on the process of picking them, I'm going so that when I go home, when they are taking showers and having tea, I go for evening run. In our culture, a man has not to go to make food for a wife, you know. So I tell Edna we have to change if we want to become successful, because you're contributing to our success if I support you.
Naona maisha ingekuwa ngumu kidogo, maana mazoezi kwanza ndio inakuanga ngumu kuliko kasi ya nyumba. Sasa naona ni mzuri, maana nikifika baada ya mazoezi napata saa ya kupumzika. Napata chakula imekuwa tayari, na hata kama kuna kazi yenye inatakikana kufanyiwa hapo nje, yeye ndiye huwa ananisaidia kufanya kasi, kasi mingi sana. Sasa naona niko na pato.
She came up the hard way. It didn't come easy. Edna worked very, very hard to be where she is. She started her athletic career around 1994-95. That's 16, 17 years ago. But now she just seems to be benefiting all the rewards of her early foundation work.
There's Edna Kiplagat of Kenya, Steve, the fastest in the field.
Yeah, she's quite comfortable, I think, just loping along. Very tall woman.
Behind her, we can see Priska Jeptu. There's a little bit of a battle on for the third place, though. We'll see how that transpired. The Ethiopian has come back to challenge. Kabidi is up there. Kiplagat looks round. Here we come, the finish. Then the first gold medal of the World Championships 2011 goes to Edna Kiplagat of Kenya, who raises her hand and crosses the line in 2:28.43. Kenya take the gold medal.
Absolutely fantastic, because I think nobody deserved it better. For her to win such a major championship race was a massive achievement, and we're all very proud of it, particularly the fact that she came from my particular small group of girls in the early years.
The pride of her country and the first gold medal of the World Championships here in Daegu for Kenya and Edna Kiplagat.
Olympic is not like normal competition, it's a structured race.
You never know what will happen. There's no certainty. Everybody's in with a chance. Everybody's there to give 100%. You know, nothing short will be accepted from anybody.
Naweza sema challenge ya kwanza ni wanariata wenye wanachakuliwa ni wako wengi sana wenye wamepata hiyo muda yenye inatakikana kuingia kwa team. Mtu unaweza kuwa selected alafu sasa baadaye hiyo muda inakuwa kidogo. Kama mwaka jana wenye tulikuwa selected kwa World Championship tulipewa muda kidogo sana yenye hata mwenye ange kuwa tayari ndio angepata nafasi ya kukimbia mzuri.
Most of the challenges is the athletes, the competitors. You never know who can make a move at any time, and all of them are front runners. And then sometimes someone can stay on your heel and you can fall down, and maybe sometimes you can miss to pick the water bottle for you, and that's another problem, because in marathon you lose a lot of water. So if you never take any sieve on the way, you will be at the end.
For David, I suppose as well, the fact that he can carry the weight of expectation and pressure from country, community, media, you know, the weight of favoritism is always difficult to cope with.
It's tough sometimes, but it's also necessary pressure to any athlete, because it also will drive you to strive to achieve that dream.
So like you are having the pattern of the whole country, and everyone is telling you, well, you have to do this. So sometimes you're asking, am I doing something right?
It's a long way to go. There's still a lot to do.
All sorts of efforts have been made to try to discover or find out if there is an inherent, instinctive or genetic reason as to why so many athletes come out of this area. No group of researchers has, as far as I know, come up with any reason or any definite advantage, instinctive advantage, that the people have that hasn't been created by their lifestyle, by their motivation, by the running culture that's around here.
We are not born runners,
but we make ourselves to be runners.
People come from peasant farming backgrounds, living largely at subsistence level. As a result, there's no give and take. You have no luxuries. Anything you get, you work for it. So family life is a disciplined life if you want to survive.
We train with whatever we have. We train hard for it. And the advantage of training hard is to win.
These series of exercises, we call them sun salute. In a sense, arm and leg movement is a distraction to the body. So you have to try to get them to synchronize that movement so that when they move their arms and their legs, as they do very much as runners, they have a control over that movement.
Okay, down and straight.
Basically with David, because he's coming off a rest period of 2 to 3 months, you have to be very, very careful to make sure that you prepare him mentally for training first. In other words, just very light workouts, thinking about his training, thinking about his season ahead.
That's Olympic, you know, I am Mungu. I'm Chukwe Uko. I find you visuri. Najua Kazi Ambio, Titungum. Kumana siki tunazo sema ati nitashinda, ukienda, ukimbia. Usebi ati I'm going there and win. Maleno ni mingi. Tunasa kuona mungina nakuja, karibu anamalisa kama hapa anaanguka. Wengine kama hii sprinters na pull muscle. Mana mingi. So najua hata mguu yake hii hapa alikuwa nimekuwa mbaya.
I'm sure a lot of people, the media included, will associate David with having to struggle in wet or chilly conditions. And of course, when you come to Olympics, you're never 100% sure of the weather conditions. The loss at the semi-final in Berlin, that hit him very hard.
I changed almost everything, my strategies, even the way of running. I started running front run. You know, the mistake that I did, of course, the weather was not good at the same time, but I did a mistake by staying behind. So I say, if I can start running from the front, it will be better. So I started training hard.
When you're challenged and you lose races, it makes you stop and think. If you learn how to lose, you will learn how to win.
I think most of the athletes and all of us, we have pressure in when you're preparing for Olympics, because most of all, you don't know if you'll be chosen to Olympics. If Edna will be selected for Olympic on target for Athletic Kenya, I will be happy man, and I will be happy because I will execute my talent and my experience as a coach to the success of Edna to bring the gold to our country. Yeah, this is what he's wearing. Navy blue Nike with number 3102. The lucky number.
Mimi nilifurahia kuchiunga na hiyo kikosi ya polisi kwa sababu wanapenda wakimbiaji. Support yao na moral na motivation iko juu sana, na nilifurahia kuchiunga na wao kuwa moja ya police officers.
This is a very Kenyan village, eh? You know, we are defending champion, yeah? So we have to have the big plaque to defend. Now I'm no longer nervous now. My adrenaline have gone down now because of I'm seeing Edna is ready. And we have done everything right for this day.
Basi hapa ni makabiliano baina ya vikosi mbalimbali.
I've never seen her starting in the PI. That shows like she has more confidence of her running.
Ninapokuwa kwa mbio, lazima niwase ni ni akina nani tunakimbia nao, wamekimbia muda gani, ni masaa gani inatakikana kukimbiliwa kwa hiyo mbio, na hivyo yote ndio ninatilia maanani, na nitakimbia namna gani kutokea mwanzo, katikati na mwisho, ili niweze nikimbie mzuri.
Nimekuambia hivi haitakuwa rahisi. Bani Chemtai, Monica Wangari wa idara ya polisi wanakuja hapa kwa hapa kumaliza mashindano. Edna Kiplagat, idara ya polisi pia anakuja kumaliza
kuweza kushinda.
Lakini Bani Chemtai,
congratulations.
Thank you, man. I did it.
You made it.
Happy enough because the training we did, we were focusing for this as our stepping stone to see how Edna is reacting to the new speed. Because this time we have a new strategy for running. She started slow and finished in the podium. So now when we go back to prepare for Marathon of London, and we are looking forward for Olympic now. That is our big goal.
You get an idea here from the short stretch how dusty the roads have become, and what's happening also with the side roads is when the dust is eventually removed by traffic and motorbikes and various things, you see the stones starting to appear through the ground, and that creates a little problem for athletes. I think if you look at all these athletes, or the successful Kenyan elite athletes, you'll find a variety of muscular structures and sizes and weights, and the same as you will in any cross-section of population. You can look at other factors that are in their lifestyle and say, for example, they run when they're young to school, so the climate makes them people of outdoor activity. They run barefoot. In a sense, maybe mentally, psychologically, the ground doesn't hold any fears for them. Whereas maybe in the Western world, as soon as we can walk or before, we have our first pair of shoes. So what's the message? The message is the ground is dangerous. It's an enemy. So in a sense that maybe they grow up with a more healthy attitude towards touching the surface of the ground. She might go 10-10, yeah. That's all.
Yes.
Otherwise, the rest of you go together. All of you go together. Don't push the ladies too hard.
Yes.
Sorry, don't push the boys too hard. Remember, these are guys, so they're not so fit. See how the smoothness, the no tension, no stress. That's his great forte in terms of running. He has a control style. He has an alignment, running with core strength, power right to the finish line. Never loses his form, never loses his shape. He is a rare. 22 is an absolute blistering time for an 800 meter runner in over 200 meters.
When you see a nice, elegant runner, really impressive, by the way they can churn out the speed and just rhythmically move, then that person, consciously or subconsciously, has come to terms with gravity and the way they relate to the ground. Very often, the more successful athletes, particularly the ones who really stand out in the world of athletics, are people who have that kind of alignment and that kind of relationship with the ground. Have you recovered enough? Because that was a fairly fast one. So just make sure you give yourself enough recovery time.
We have a perfect weather today here. Yeah?
The London Marathon is so important to us because it's first of all is the selection for Kenya team to the Olympics.
We made this kind of a loop to be similar to the race in London because London is a loop course, similar dance and everything, so that we, when Edna is running in London, is thinking how the course of London is. Two kinds of training you have to get used to. Drinking water, and then before any training you have to get used to eating something before the training. For the last 3 weeks we have been trained by Grace Momanyi. She came to attend to prepare for Olympics trial for 10,000. So, but in my opinion, if I see her, she has more speed and she's strong. She is a strong woman. We started from high elevation, 2,380, going down to 2,200. And back again to the elevation.
Ah, go back. Aye, there. Ah, back to the guy. Ah, go back.
Gets the first race of the day underway, the elite women's field. Let's salute these athletes as they get underway. Perfect racing conditions and London Olympic places up for grabs.
Edna Kiplagat, the world champion, who's hung on well. And if she runs like that in the Olympic Games, I would suggest that, well, she will immediately have placed herself as an early favourite for the gold medal. So Edna Kiplagat takes second place. It's going to be just inside the 2:20 mark for Kiplagat, and that will be a new personal best for her as well.
Wakati nilipopita kwa line, nilifurahi sana kwa sababu ili tulipata ile matokeo yenye tulikuwa tumepanga. Nikifumilia na nifanye vyema, niliona tulifanikiwa sana na ilikuwa ni furaha sana.
I call it a breakthrough for us because we make a preparation from last year, going to London and then look eyeing for Olympics. The result is London. It's making me very happy because every race at now is improving. Like last year 2:20 and then this year 2:19, that's happy, and it's a green light for us to go for Olympics.
We've decided to nominate the following: Mary Kaitany, Edna Kiplagat, and Briska Jepto.
I'll thank Edna because to train for the quality, it's not something easy. It needs mental strategy and all the plans.
You know, you can't just say that everything's gonna be alright. Sometimes you don't know this up and down, but we are trying to do our best to see that we can tackle this thing and bring this glory here in Italy.
ne mama ombe. Ombe mama ombe. Ombe.
To prepare someone mentally, you need first of all to get someone to get rid of fear of the distance. And then you have to let the body understand the stress. The training is so important when you do a long run in an easy base fast, and then get used to like listen to his breathing, change of the breathing in the hill, on the slope, on the fast. After that, you come now focusing for the time. If you combine the spirit, your self-concern and your body and the mind to come in and unifies one body, you can make it. Because when the mind say I'm not ready, or the mind say you are ready and the body say no, your muscle, you're not running. You have to be ready and more relaxed in mind to have to be mentally in a race. Because training is 60%, but running 40% is mentally.
It makes you stop and think about your running, about your training, about your approach to the races, about the tactics you use. And David is a great student of his event, so he practically always learns something. When I see him running like this today, roughly this time last year, an injury. He went out for an easy run in the morning. We were going to meet here for a track session. He rings me and says, I've just twisted my ankle. Oh, God, is that just what we didn't want? So it kind of brings back visions of this time last year. A lot of David's 800 meter running, and I suppose that's what makes him such an attractive 800 meter run, is his rhythmic running. He's big into rhythm. And anything that accepts his rhythm can be a factor. I think you kind of, as a coach, you have to capitalize on whatever that athlete brings to you, rather than trying to impose something that you think he should have. When I would watch him doing a long distance endurance, I'm not necessarily looking for a time. I'm just looking for a control and a poise and a way of doing it. It's a way of doing it. I feel, I get feedback from watching him, that he's in control of what he's doing. He's not in the reserve tank. And this is one of the first times I've seen him doing a session on the track with the earphones.
I listen to all music, Christian, lyrics, R&B, blues. Yeah, but a few special, but I normally don't tell anybody about that. It's my secret. I listen before every race.
He knows the importance of Olympics. He knows the importance of world championships. He knows the importance of world records. There are a lot of little things that make him what he is.
I'm very confident, and the important things, you know, in the Kenyan trail is not about time.
The national championships prove very useful for us because they're a kind of a pre-Olympic scenario where he has to run heats, semi-finals and finals. And that's a very good thing for him because it gives him confidence of putting three good races together, and we see him running very well over 3 days.
That I want to watch today is actually David Rudisha. He's a friend, admire his talent, his discipline, and I wish other Kenyans could emulate what he does best.
It's not that they're selling their individual names, but general Kenyan name.
Proud to be Kenyan.
I often find that many coaches, including myself, before a major race, get even more nervous than the athlete, because sometimes the athlete has some way of letting go of his frustrations and worries and tensions by going out and warming up, and like David, by putting on his earphones and things like that. Whereas the coach is left waiting and waiting and waiting, just wondering what's going on in the mind of the athlete. You know, so there's 101 different things go through your head just within 30 minutes or so of a race. This is it, as far as he's concerned, even before the Olympics. This is the first round of the Olympics, you know, because he really has only one paced race between now and the Olympics, you know. So I'm pleased with it, and he's got it out, he's done his job, and let's wait for the final on Saturday. Every race is a fight. The day you stop fighting is the day you stop losing your concentration and losing your focus. But the fight is a psychological preparation in advance. It's never easy in the mind.
I'm very happy today, a lot, because as a coach, to have someone in Olympics is very important for me. I think I achieved something which I've been looking for. I'm so happy.
Tunaomba Mungu tu tuendelee kufanya vyema mpaka hiyo wakati.
It's a lot of sacrifice that we also make, and this is what make you to become a champion. You know, you have to take a lot of things, you know, you have to put them aside to achieve this, because it is important in our lives.
Olympics are so special. I think for any athlete in any sport, an Olympic medal is their dream.
I'm very excited. This is going to be one of my biggest competition, and of course being the world record holder, the world champion, going to Olympic is very important for me, because this is the medal that I've been longing for, and it's the only thing that I'm missing in my career.
Into the race, the medal contenders became clear, with runners from Kenya and Ethiopia leading the way. Another Kenyan in the pack was the reigning world champion, Edna Kiplagat. As the pace picked up, Kiplagat would fall back. It was down to four with only kilometers to go. The two-time London Marathon winner, Keatney, Tiki Jelana of Ethiopia, Priska Jeptu of Kenya, and the Russian Arkhipova. 24-year-old Jelena would cross the finish line in 2 hours, 23 minutes, and 7 seconds, a new Olympic record, besting the old mark by 7 seconds.
Colors right on the outside. Khaki also. Khaki's on the shoulder of Rudisha, but it's Rudisha holding the inside lane. It's Rudisha from Khaki, from Amman, from Keaton. It's fast. It's around 24.6 for the first 200 meters. This could be something very special. Take a check on the time. It's quick, very quick. 49.28. That Olympic record looks set to go. The teenagers are lining up behind him. Amman is now trying to get into second place, but it's Rudisha pushing on ahead. Keaton also still looking good there behind. But Takaki is doing his best to hold on, but none of them are good enough to hold on to Rudisha. Amman is now into second. Takaki is back into fourth. What's the time at 600? Why? 1:14:30. We have something very, very special on here. As Amos, the other junior now, comes into second ahead of Amman. It's Rudisha coming into home straight. We're going to look at the time very closely on this one. A brilliant run by the youngster, Amos, who just comes into second place. The other youngster, Keaton, is in third place now. Then a man, the three youngsters, with solid finishing. But Rudisha, what's the time? It's a world record! A world record here in London. from the Olympic Games, from the greatest medalist of runner we've seen for a very long time. It's David Rudisha, 1:40.91 is turning on the clock. A full tenth of a second off the world record, and he did it, leading all the way. This is one of the greatest runs we've seen in Olympic history. He's retained his title 50 years after and it's 50 years.
This is one of the great races in Olympic history. A world record set in the 800 metres. He promised it and he delivered. And really, when he started to go away, this is Amos in the silver medal position. When he started to go away, then no one could stay with him. But Amos, what a talent. But Rudisha, absolutely formidable here. He ran it all the way. He doesn't need pacemakers. He can do it himself, and he's proved it here. And to do it in the final of the Olympic Games is quite incredible. 1:40.91 is astonishing, absolutely astonishing. He promised it, and he delivered it.